गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल बी स्टडिंग अ चैप्टर कॉल्ड स्ट्रैटेजीज फॉर एनहांसमेंट इन फूड प्रोडक्शन. नाउ दिस चैप्टर यू कैन वेरी वेल अंडरस्टैंड द टॉपिक स्ट्रैटेजीज फॉर एनहांसमेंट इन फूड प्रोडक्शन. एज यू ऑलरेडी नो दैट वी आर अ डेंसली पॉपुलेटेड कंट्री एंड फूड रिक्वायरमेंट इज मच मोर इन इंडिया and China as compared to any other country. We have been busy in enhancing our total food production. Now, food production does not only include the crops, but also includes food from various other sources, such as food derived from animals, besides plants, from milk, from products of milk, fishes, all aquatic animals, including fishes, mollusk, crustaceans, then food from poultry farming, food from apiculture or bee culture. So all these are included in food production. So we have been trying to raise our total food production since very long time. And the reason is that our population is growing at a very fast rate. So naturally, we have to raise the food production. Now, in this chapter, we are going to read about all the strategies, the mechanism which are being adopted for increasing our food production. So we will be talking about first animal husbandry. Now let us begin with this chapter as such. See, it is the agriculture practice of breeding and raising livestock. So animal husbandry is actually a agriculture practice of breeding and raising livestock. Now it does not include only cattle such as buffaloes, cows, goat, sheep, etc. But also, it also includes fisheries and poultry farming. So basically, animal husbandry includes all those animals which are used for food production as such. Okay, first we'll be looking at dairy farm management. Management of cattle for obtaining milk and its product for consumption by people. That is the definition of dairy farm management. It is a kind of management of cattle to get milk and milk products from them for the consumption of people. Now, there can be better strategies in order to obtain huge amount of milk and its product. Now we will be discussing about all those strategies in this particular topic. In case of dairy farm management, see, it's a layman topic. Anyone can tell points. Anyone can speak on this topic. What is the first and the most important requirement in order to raise the yield? Now, naturally, selection of disease resistant and high producing cattle is the basic requirement. Disease resistant as well as high yield, cattle having high yield. That is the first and the most important requirement in dairy farm management. The first is selecting good or better breeds of cattle so that the milk can be enhanced, milk production can be enhanced. What is the second most important thing? The place where they are kept, that has to be very hygienic. Clean and hygienic atmosphere should be provided to the cattle. What is the third most important factor? So first is, I'll be writing here, selection of high yielding and disease free variety. Disease free variety, that is the first important point here. Now what is the second important point? Providing clean and hygienic environment to the cattle. Providing clean and hygienic environment to the cattle, the place where the cattle are kept. Third, providing proper fodder both quality wise as well as quantity wise, that is balanced diet has to be provided to the cattle so that it can have high yield. So that is another requirement. Fourth point, milking storage and transport facility should be present. Proper milking storage and transport facility should be provided. Transport facility. Should be provided. See, milking, storage and transport facility. Today we know that in most of the cases where in India as well as in abroad, all these things have been mechanized, especially milking has been mechanized these days. So there are very minimum chances of contamination. So now another point is that regular visit by a veterinary doctor is very essential. Veterinary doctor is essential. Then the next thing is proper record keeping is essential. It is very essential to have a proper record keeping. Record keeping में कुछ, जैसे मान लीजिए कुछ आपकी cows या cattle बीमार हैं, उनको अलग रखना, segregate करके रखना, किस में क्या problem हो रही है, किस stage में वो cattle है, कहीं menstruation के menstrual cycle के phase में कोई cow तो नहीं है, कोई बीमार तो नहीं है, इस बात का ध्यान रखा जाता है. Proper उसकी record keeping होती है, that is very essential part. So these are the all the things which has to be practiced for proper dairy management in order to enhance the milk production. It is very essential. ओके, नाउ लेट अस टॉक अबाउट पोल्ट्री फार्म मैनेजमेंट. पोल्ट्री फार्म मैनेजमेंट, सी दिस इज द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ birds in order to provide eggs and meat, that is called as poultry farm management. Now usually the birds which we manage or we keep is chicken and ducks, but apart from that turkeys and geese can also be kept. They provide us meat as well as eggs. Now what are the strategies for poultry farm management? The same strategies which we have followed for dairy farm management will be applied in poultry farm management also for a good yield. For example, selection of disease-free birds and high-yielding birds, that is criteria number one. Criteria number second, it has to be kept at a place which is hygienic and clean. Criteria number third, proper record keeping should be maintained. Then the fourth number, which is important, the birds should be regularly visited by a veterinary doctor. That poultry farm should be visited by a veterinary doctor. So these are the things which has to be kept in mind while managing the poultry farm. Thank you. We will be starting with our next topic in our next lecture, that is about animal breeding. Thank you. Have a nice day.